Hey everyone, and once again, welcome to Google Ads course. Myself, Umar Taskeer. Guys, in this particular video, we are basically going to explore the different elements which are there in our text copy, which are there in our actual text copy, right? So, whenever we are about to create an ad, we have different options, right? So, whenever you will be clicking on this small plus button, as you can see on my laptop screen, you will get the options of text ad, right? So, you can create the text ad. You can also create responsive search ad. You can also create call ad. And you can also create responsive display ads. So you have these many options over here. But right now we are going to talk about only expanded text ad, right? So we'll be clicking on this expanded text ad over here, and then it will ask about the campaign and the ad group where we want to put our ad, right? So I'll click on this ad, and now let me first clean all these things which is there, right? So it's already there. So we have to clean this thing first, and then we will talk about all these different elements which are present over here, right? So let's begin. So you can see this ad will be there in this specific ad group, right? And this specific campaign. So you have some basic information over here, and this particular text ad is in progress that you are about to create. And then there is another text ad which is there in this specific ad group, right? So this is basically a very, very basic kind of information about where our text ad is, right? Then on the right side, we have this preview option, where we can see the preview based on the different devices. As we can see over here, we are seeing the preview on mobile device over here, and then we are seeing how it is going to look on desktop, and then we are seeing that how our text ad will look when it is shown on different websites, like a display ad, right? So if you are opting that okay, I'm creating a search ad, but I wanted to show this ad on display network also, then this is how it is going to appear, right? So it will be more clear once we are done filling all these information. So once this information is all complete over here, we'll be really able to figure out that how it is actually going to look in this display banner, right? So let's start with this thing. Now this one is the final URL, right? So whatever our landing page is, or wherever we want traffic to be diverted, we are going to put that specific URL over here. So for example, if we want our traffic to be landing on this specific landing page, our website, our official website, you can copy this thing simply, right? And then we can use this as our landing page URL, or as our final URL, right? So after clicking on this ad, the users or the visitors will be redirected to this specific page. Now this is called as final URL. So we'll write this final URL over here. Then we have three headlines options over here, but one thing we have to make sure that we have to insert all the important elements in the first two headlines only. So we have three headlines over here. We can write something like this: number one, digital marketing agency. Okay, so now you can see on the right side how it is going to look on different devices, right? So this is really a good thing over here. So we are writing a headline one over here, which should be there within 30 characters. Number one, digital marketing agency, right? Digital marketing services. And let's see if we can enter this, or it will be out of characters. Yes, it is, will be out of characters. We have to make sure that whatever content we are writing over here, it should fix the limitations which are basically defined by Google, right? Then we have another option over here which says headline third, so we can write WS Cube Tech over here, fine. And then we have this display path option. So now whenever your ad will trigger, and whenever it will appear in the search in the result pages, whatever final URL you have entered over here, it is not going to show up over there. The URL that will be shown over there is something like this, display URL, right? So why it happens is, sometimes we have a very long final URL. Suppose we are like, let's select one URL like iPhone, Amazon, and let's select any product. Okay, here it is, right? So if you see this URL, it's too long, right? It's too long. This URL is too long. And let's open the notepad. So you can see this URL is very long, right? It's too long. So you can see this URL is very long. So guys, if you are putting this URL over here as your final URL, and it is the thing which is going to show up in the Google search engine result pages, it is going to create a lot of problem. Like we can write iPhone or buy iPhones, and suppose if this one is your ad, let's see if we can see any ad. Yes, here it is, right? If these are your ad, now you can see the URLs over here. So whenever we click on this URL, right, it is something different, like shop, buy iPhone, iPhone 11. So the final URL is something different on which we are actually redirected. But what we see over here in the Google search engine result pages is totally different, right? The thing that we are seeing over here is basically the display path, right? So you have to put something like this only. So whatever your final URL will be, that will come automatically over here, right? Your domain basically. So whatever we are putting over here, like if we want to redirect traffic on this specific page of digital marketing training, let's say digital marketing training page, okay? So we wanted to drive traffic on this specific page. So we will put this specific page as final URL over here. So this is not going to appear over here. So what will be visible over here is like WS Cube Tech and whatever we are mentioning over here, like services and then digital marketing, okay, or Google Ads or whatever you want, right? PPC services, we can write this thing. Guys, this one is a great thing that you have to consider, right? So this is how your ad will appear on the search engine result pages with this display path option or display path content showing over here. And the reason is because sometimes your final URLs are too lengthy, which is actually not a good thing to show in the Google search engine result pages, right? Then we have description, and these two descriptions are very important, and we can put our important keywords over here, and we have to make sure that we do not exceed the limit. So we have to write maximum things, maximum and maximum things within this 90 characters, right? So once we start writing like, okay, looking for digital marketing services in India, we provide India's one of the best PPC services or service, right? So it is exceeding, and looking for digital marketing services in India, we will write one of the best services. Okay, I'm just writing very random. We have to make sure that our copy is good, right? So then we can write SEO services, and we can also write like PPC services. We can write content marketing services, and then we can write video services. So all these things we can write, right? We are specialized. Now let's remove this video services from here, right? So let's correct it. Now this is how your ad will actually look, right? So you have to understand the importance of each and every element, each and every section which is present over here while you are creating a new text ad. And parallelly, you have to see how it is going to appear on the different devices, like on desktop. And then you have to make sure that how it is looking. Then you have to make sure that how it is actually looking on the mobile, because this is something very important. You have to check your ad preview on mobile devices first, right? Because nowadays, most of the searches are happening from mobile devices only. So you have to make sure that everything is perfect on the mobile devices. And then we have display one, right? So whenever you select display network, your search ad will appear on different websites like this, right? So you have this open button over here, and even clicking on this open button, they will be redirected to this final URL, the landing page, right? And then here is the H1, here is the H2. And then here comes the description one, right? So this is basically the anatomy of a text ad, where we are having one final URL column section and three headlines, right? And then we have a display path section. Then we have two descriptions of 90 characters each. And then we have add URL option also. So we can use different tracking templates to track things through the URL. I'll be talking about this thing later in the upcoming videos. So that's it for this specific video. See you in the next video. Till then, goodbye.